Hi, this is Troy from the do-it-yourself world and the off-grid project. I think you will notice something different today. I am recording in HD, and you'll probably notice a lack of shakiness in my video. I finally broke down and went and got a camera at Walmart. It's not expensive. Wish I'd done this years ago. But anyway, this is my first time out with my camera. Just checking out the garden. It's been raining again. It's really, well, overcast. It hasn't really rained much. Just disgusting out. My chickens were out again, and they have made an absolute mess of my mulch. Actually, it looks really ugly now. They've completely trashed the mulch. They've completely taken it all away from around the base of my plant, here and here, and absolutely every piece of it's gone from the base of this plant. So I clipped them. Two of the little tiny black ones, that one right there looking at me, has its wings clipped, and one of the other ones, the really black one over there. So I have another problem. But it is, I can't believe the gardening. I don't know if this is New York or if it's just this year or where I'm located, but I am having struggles. Something has gone and killed every one of my brand new beans. The top has been eaten off. See this one? See how this looks? How much of growth is on there now? And see how tall it is? It's been cut off. Completely cut off. Same here. Cut off. Well, there's a bean that wants to grow. I'll give him a chance here. Get him in there. Especially, look here. See the pods? Broken off, laying on the ground. Something is running through here. See, here's another one. Completely destroyed. This one's missing a leaf. Here, eaten. There's a bean that wants to grow. It looks like Nance got it. All of them, all gone. The whole row. It's all gone. I lost every one of my beans in this row. I'm so upset. So, I have to do something about the chipmunk population here if I'm going to have a garden. They may be cute, but they're vicious, evil little critters that prefer my food from my garden. So, I got a live trap. I'm going to have to start catching them, getting rid of them. I have one bean that's good and two that might pull out of it. Out of a whole row, I've got one good bean left. I'm gonna have to replant, and I haven't even finished planting in the first place. Peas are looking good. Peas are doing really well. So we'll see how that goes later. And besides that, I think everything else is doing all right. The gnats are so bad right now. They're going for my eyeballs. I'm going to have to wear a full head net, and they're on my hands, to be able to even come out here at all for any extended time. That and the mosquitoes. With this overcast weather, the mosquitoes are a nightmare. And I'm serious, if you don't dunk yourself fully under in mosquito spray, they're going to get you. All of my berries are spreading out happily. You see how my zoom looks here. I've got 30 times optical zoom. So, on this new camera. So, berries are looking nice. Spreading out nicely now. I don't know what's killing the leaves on these guys. And all of my berries are turning black. I don't know if that's normal or what's the deal with that. But again, I've never had a lot of success with strawberries before. These, that one dried up. That one's ugly, turning brown. That one's probably not gonna make it. But the plants are spreading out, so next year I'll have good berries anyway, good crop of berries. Here we're looking good so far. I'm hoping the marigolds will help deter any worms. I might even put a few more marigolds out just to be sure. But oh, that's gonna be some good food. That's pretty with the water spots on the plants too. Very nice, look at that. This seems to be a good camera. I checked online the reviews. I got a discount at Walmart because I was upset when I went there. They didn't have any the other camera that I wanted, so I had to get one better, so they gave me a discount, so that's good. Look at this cauliflower. That's coming along nice. Oh, that's good. I might go back and get some more of these if they have them, because honestly, for the price, for the for six, it's really worth it, I think. They're growing nice. So I'm gonna have very good results here. Everything here is looking good as well, but the white weeds in the wild is taking over. There especially, you can see all the growth around the plants. Really bad. There's my corn. Right here in the middle, there's the row of corn. But look at the weeds. Oh wow. Got some work to do. With this rain comes weeds. A lot of them. Look at them all. I'm just gonna have to get a hoe and completely work this dirt in a sunny day. Completely worked it up. That's why the back to Eden method was beneficial, because it'll block this from happening. Well, the rest of my tomatoes are good. Onions are looking good. The ones that survived being kicked out of the dirt earlier, they're all coming along well. Well, you can see the gnats now, can't you? The weeds are especially bad up in here. But again, I'll hoe that out when the sun ever comes up again. It'll kill them. And then I'll have to throw mulch in between all these plants too. Once I hoe that up and let the weeds dry and die out, then I'll put mulch down. That'll help. My tomatoes are coming along nicely. Where is it? There it is. Oh, this is a high quality camera. I'm liking this already. Really high definition. I don't know what it'll look like once I get the video going on the computer and then get it up online, but we'll find out, I guess. Well, yeah, those guys are gonna have to be transplanted. I'd be curious to see what happened if I left them. But they'll have to get transplanted. Might leave a few just for kicks. And then spread the rest out. Anyway, garden's looking pretty good. But with the moist weather came the mosquitoes and the gnats in force. What a nightmare. I'm sure you can see them flying around in front of the screen. Just terrible. Alright, well, I'm going to go look around and see what I'm going to do with my day now. It's 4:30 in the afternoon. I went to town. I worked on the computer all morning. And then I went to town and got the camera and shopped around for a good deal. It takes time to pick something like this because it's important. So now it's pretty late in the day and the bugs are just a nightmare. So I'll have to go see. Yeah, look at them. The camera's picking them up nicely, isn't it? You can see them well, can't you? That's what's going around my face. That's what my head looks like right now. It's just a nightmare. So, anyway, I'll catch y'all in a little bit, see what I'm going to do with the day now that I'm back. I unpacked my backpack from the weekend and left it sitting here on the bed. And the baby cat has decided to use it as a bed. They say that cats, because they love you, they will sleep on your stuff. Do you love me, baby cat? Huh? You're too lazy to even twitch, aren't you? Hmm? She wants to smell stuff. Still sleep on your paperwork, still sleep in your backpack, your computer, whatever that's close to you, they'll sleep on if they love you. Right? I have an envelope here. Came in the mail, obviously. Alright, there's a little bit of a letter and something stuck inside of it. Let me see what we got here. Oh, alright, it's a letter. Hold on, I'm going to pause a minute. Ah, this is from Irish Kitty. And there is a little packet here. Sorry, I don't want to disclose any personal information. So, there's a little packet here containing a mess of little seeds. There's bee balm, which is a deer repellent. Bluebells, deer repellent. Yeah, she says give baby cat a kiss on the head. So there's a whole bunch of little things here. Let me see if we can get these out and look at them. There's the bee balm. Very nice. Let me see. There's double impa. I think I'm reading that right. Double. I'm not sure if I'm reading that right. I don't even know what it is. There's bluebells. There's baby cat. You want your kiss? I'll do that off camera if you don't mind. White moon flower. There's some things I haven't heard of before. African daisy. What's this here? Purple iris. Oh, pretty. And we have yellow daylilies. Very nice. Well, when I get my new flower bed done, which will be pretty soon, I'm clearing all those trees out, I'll be planting these. Actually, I'll probably start these in the greenhouse so I get a head start. Well, thank you very much. Gonna be nice this year. Gonna be pretty. Thank you, Irish Kitty. I was at Home Depot today, and I was looking at samples for my flooring inside the tiny home. And I've got here, this is super, super thin and ultra light. And this is a self-stick, this is a vinyl material, but it looks like wood. I'm looking at lightweight durability, and because I can only have 7,000 pounds in my on my camper frame. So I've got these samples here. This is a this is the self-stick version, and it's, again, super thin. So that's definitely going to be helpful as far as weight goes. I'd love to have real wood flooring, but I just, honestly, I can't do it with that trailer frame. What do we have here? Blonde maple. Now this is, I think, my favorite. This was like $1.78 a foot, which is one of the cheapest flooring materials they had in there. Here's a bamboo look, which in the store looked pretty nice, but a friend of mine said he didn't like the bamboo grain there in the middle. And I have to say, I sort of agree. And here was a, this was a floating floor. These snap together like a puzzle. But it's twice the thickness. And of course, it's going to be twice the weight. And this is a rustic maple. So I think with the samples that I have here, I think I'm going to go with the, this blonde maple, unless I can find a tongue and groove plywood that I can sand and varnish and leave as is on the flooring, a 3/4 inch tongue and groove plywood. Otherwise, I'll be putting down some of this material throughout the whole complete home, from the porch, throughout the kitchen, living room, and the bathroom, and the whole works. So that's another thing I was doing today. I was looking at samples. I was looking at kitchens, bathrooms, insulation options, siding options, roofing options. I spent quite a few hours asking help, asking for professionals for their help and advice, and looking at materials and doing comparisons to see what I'm going to go with. I'm really solidifying my tiny home in my mind now. This is a very, very massive box that was waiting for me when I got home from the weekend. I'm only just getting to it. It was there yesterday. But it was raining all day pretty hard, so I didn't go get it. It was up on the porch of the house. It comes direct from Amazon, so let's see what's in here. Oh, this is going in my garden. This is perfect. Perfect for the walkways. Oh, wow, look at that. Wow, this is huge. I think, if I remember right, this was from the prairies. It said, I will never have to worry about burlap again. This is going to be good to protect my trees, especially next year when the fruit forms. This is a massive amount of burlap. That's a huge bag. I can't even get it in the camera and it's so huge. And there's some twine there, 520 feet of jute twine. Actually, jute twine is an awesome fire starting material, by the way, for survival fire starting. I've done videos on that. I'll probably do another fire starting video in the future one day. But jute twine, if you take apart the individual strands and fluff it up, it is a really good fire starter. It's also very good for gardening work. So thank you very much. Boy, this is massive. How much do we have here? Natural, biodegradable, organic. Let's see, for soil erosion, landscaping, tree wrap, tree balling, plant protection, windscreen, decorating crafts. How many feet is this? It doesn't say, does it? Whatever, it's huge. It is really huge. Yeah, you're right. I'll never have to worry about burlap again. Well, thank you very much. That is a huge amount of burlap. And I don't know if you realize this, but this is bonus material right here. Find the end of this. See how wide this is. I think, yes, look at this. I've got the walkways for my garden. And this is probably going to be enough to cover my garden walkways. Awesome bonus. Look at that. That's going to cover my garden walkway. All of that. I think I probably got enough to do a pretty good share of it. Well, thank you. Got a lifetime supply of burlap and tree wrap. And bonus. Well, thanks a lot. Well, I'm going to walk in here and see if my little hen is laying eggs or not yet. The little birds are probably going to have a fit and think I'm going to feed them, as they always do. Oh, check this out. I can barely walk. They're all over my feet. Look at this. They're swarming around in front of my feet. Look at them all. Is this? Oh, there we go. Thing was zoomed in. I didn't realize this has a memory of staying zoomed in. Or whatever it was last. Look at these guys. Right in front of my feet. They think they're getting fed. Little birds. Look, I can barely walk without almost stepping on a bird. Oops, I just stepped on a bird's foot. Alright, let me see if I can get around here. They act like they've never been fed in weeks, but I feed them way more than I should, honestly. Oh, she didn't today. Bummer. Well, anyway, I wanted to show you. I wanted to surprise you and show you that I got two eggs. But now she isn't laying again. I wonder why that is. She laid two eggs and then stopped. I was going to bring you out here and show you. And now she isn't laying. Look at these monsters, like they haven't been fed in forever. And when I check, they're full. That one bit me. Come here. Come here. You guys, look, they're stuffed. Their gullets are full. full of food. They've been eating well all day long, and yet they beg for food. Well, now you can see my birds up close. Look at them, HD birds. High definition chickens. Now you get to look at them closely. There's my silkies. There's my little puffball. I'm trying to tame that one right there. That one's special. That one's a big rooster. That silky right there is a rooster. I'm pretty sure, yeah, it's a rooster. And that one, I am afraid, is going to be a rooster. I'm not quite sure. And that one's probably a girl, the pufferball, right here. She's a pretty bird. So, there's a little rooster. That's a pretty little rooster. I'm taming him. Whoop. Sit still. Come here. I had to clip his wings the other day. Hold on. There you go. He's one of the ones I had to clip the other day because he was getting into my garden, making a mess. Won't be doing it again for a while. Here's the other one I clipped, a little black one. Well, let me see if I can fight my way out of here. Well, it seems like most of my videos start from here recently. It's 8:30, getting dark. Really good, gonna be good to see how this camera works out here. Image stabilization and taking away my bouncy walk. I'll show you something interesting here. I don't know if I really want to do this again. I'll set this up. I found out my electric fence works, but I found out my shoes are insulating against the electric fence wire. Stand here all day long, nothing happens. Although I'm not even sure this is connecting at all. I'm going to do an experiment. This is scary because I got quite a zap earlier. Yeah, the fence works. When I ground my knee to the ground, I get a good zap. My shoes are quite insulating. I thought for a while there my fence wasn't working. And so I went around feeling it, and I was like, no, it's defective. It's not working. I let my chicken's life depend on this. And I started looking around, and there was some grass touching it in places. So I pulled the grass away, and I kept testing the wire and testing the wire, and nothing happened. So I got the idea to kneel down, and I touched it, and wow, I let out a yell. I was in a very wet spot when I did it, and grounded myself out really nicely. So yeah, the fence works well, and my shoes are very good grounding. These are Reeboks. Very, very good ground. Now I've been out here all afternoon. I moved my snake, my plastic snake, to protect my last bean plants. There's only two left, one and a half sort of. So anyway, I put him here. Now I came through and I did two more rows of popcorn on the outside edges of this, and I'll have four rows of popcorn in here, and I've got beans along one side, peas along the other, all the way down, and back here at the far back edge, right here was nothing before. So I put in some lima beans and some other big fat beans, I forgot the name. And then some green beans and some wax beans over here. I finally got this row done. This whole row is now carrots and turnips and beets. I have, I think it's the first row. Oh, I got bugs crawling on me right and left. I think this whole row is different types of beets. And that outside row is different types of carrots. All four different types of carrots on one side, four different types of beets on this row. And I've got two rows of rich vegetables in the middle. Actually, only one row, sorry. Well, I did actually, what I did is took a three-pronged rake and I went along like this, and then like this, and then like this. And so I've got the triple row here, but I spaced them out as I went along the row, so they're not too crowded. And then in the middle, I've got various, I have to double check. I did it in a hurry because the mosquitoes are so bad and the gnats are so horrible. But I put, what I got, radishes? Yeah, radishes, kohlrabi, and two other things in the middle. I'll have to look when I get back inside. I did it in a hurry. So, I've got one more row that'll probably be a second sowing of some root vegetables later. I'm going to have a lot more carrots and beets. Oh, I've got turnips in here. Yeah, did I say turnips? Turnips, beets, and carrots were the main things I put here. That's what it was. I've got a little section here between the peppers and the cabbage family to fill up. As I said, I may go back and see if they got any more of them left. It'll be nice to get some later planting, because the ones in the shop are still tiny. They didn't grow like they are out here. So mine, although they were planted and started at the same time, mine are growing better, of course, because they're out in nature. So I might do a second planting, so I'll have a staggered harvest of my favorite vegetables here. I think I have plenty peppers now. It's going to be a lot. And then I plan on keeping some of the pepper plants for in my porch next year for overwintering. They should survive. Over here, I still have to do my pumpkins and my squash and my acorn squash and my melons, and that's all that's going to go there in that row. It's really weedy though. I don't know. It's a mess. I think what I'm going to do is put the paper down all the way around and just have a gap in the middle where my row of vines will go. So, it's looking good now. I threw the birds some popcorn. They are happy picking up all the popcorn seed. Just plain old popcorn off the shelf I planted here. And I've done it before and it has grown. So this is the black popcorn. It's supposed to be very nutritious for you. I think, no, I don't see it yet. I haven't seen any sprouting. Well, there's one. I think, or is it or is it not? Yeah, I think there's a popcorn coming up. I think I have one here. Possibly. It's hard to tell so soon. But if it is going to grow, it's starting out slow. Yeah, there's one there. There's popcorn coming up. And that might be one there. Yep, there's one. Yeah, the popcorn sprouted. I also scattered some on top of the ground. I have a whole ton of popcorn. And just to see what will happen. Denser is better in this case. All through the middle here, there's nothing but corn. So that'll help them pollinate each other nicely. So this row is done. Completely done. I'm going to have to buy some more beans because, as I said, the whole first row is gone. The whole first section of the row up to that thing is gone. The second section either hasn't sprouted or it's already been eaten. That row's done. That row's completely done. That row's almost completely done. That row's almost, that row is completely done. And then on this row, all I have to do is spread out these vines throughout the row, and that row will be done. Actually, just I'm going to put some here. From these guys, put a few there, put a few there, and put a few there, and that's it. Finished. And then put paper down around everything to kill off all this massive grass growth. Really insane grass. Well, that's it for the night. First day testing out my real HD video camera. And I'm going to pick up my cup that had the corn in it and take it in. Well, see y'all tomorrow. I'm going to see how this camera looks.